Hi, this is Dr. Lakshmi. I'm specialized in diabetes nutrition. So let me today we are going live with the I'm going to clear your diabetes queries and the myths. So you can reach out to me here and ask your queries related to diabetes for your purpose and for family friend. So let's start now. Hi Gunjan, hi Shalkura. Yes. So, hi Raj. Yes. So start with the diabetes. So today, 14th November is the World Diabetes Day. Okay, so we are celebrating for every year 14 November, and this year theme is the family and the diabetes. Yeah, hi Vishal. Yes, hi Anshum, Anusha. Yeah, this family and the diabetes means, so this is creating the awareness. This is a 2 years camp that we are conducting, that International Diabetic Federation has conducted 2 years of awareness in diabetes. So educating the people regarding the educating the people regarding awareness about the complications and regarding the awareness and educating the family how to give a proper support to the diabetes clients. Yeah, hi Gunjan, thank you so much for your appreciation. Yes. Yeah, Truweight is doing a fab job in helping people get stay fit. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you so much, Gunjan, for your appreciation. Yes, so here, whatever the queries you are having regarding the diabetes, you can post me. We'll be here till 12:30 live. Okay. Yes. Yeah, so the creating the awareness, what we have observed is awareness regarding the diabetes is helping us to control our condition better and controlling our complications better. This is to avoid complications in future. So diabetes is a metabolic disease. So metabolic disease is always contributing the conditions, like it may lead to the complications in future, like creating the problems in eyes, creating the problems in kidneys condition and the liver condition if we leave it untreated. Okay, so that's the reason we always keep the awareness, like how frequently do we need to visit the doctor, how frequently do we need to monitor our blood sugar levels. What is the carbohydrates that we need to take? And what are the sources of carbohydrates that we need to take? Carbohydrates, always we get the myth that we have to avoid completely carbohydrates to cure our blood sugars, otherwise to maintain our blood sugar levels. But the thing is, we can take the carbohydrates. It depends on what kind of carbohydrates we need to take. Yes, so what kind of carbohydrates, like whether it is the simple carbohydrates or complex carbohydrate, what kind of carbohydrates? So it is the complex carbohydrates. Yes, so complex carbohydrates means, yes, Vivan, is it free of cost? Yes, can you please elaborate your questions? Yeah, hi, Kirta. Hi, Vishal. How can I keep my family away from diabetes? Yes, Vishal. So diabetes, what we can consider, it is a lifestyle related condition. So it is it can be controlled by following the healthy lifestyle. Healthy lifestyle in the sense of to avoiding the sedentary lifestyle and following the balanced meal and avoiding all the refined products like maida and the white rice and adding more of vegetables and the fruits in the diet, keeping ourselves healthy and maintaining a healthy weight, we can always keep our family away from the diabetes. Hi Srividya. Hi Kirta, Kirti. Yes, so creating the awareness in our family. how to create awareness. So if we are having any how to reduce by dieting. Yes, so how to reduce by dieting? Reducing the weight by dieting is following the balanced diet. So our body must need a carbohydrate, it must need protein, and it must need fat. And it only depends on how we take. The balanced meal pattern, like following the 5 frequent meal pattern instead of following the 2 main meal or 3 or only 2 main meals in a day, it will not help us to reduce our weight properly. Other than that, we will go on lacking with some other micronutrients or the macronutrients. You have to take the carbohydrates in the in a manner that it should be complex carbohydrate. And it should be the balanced with fiber. So if you follow the balanced meal plan, you can reduce the weight fast. Give diet chart. Kita, so here we cannot give the diet chart. And how to, Anusha, hi, how to follow weight loss diet with diabetes. Yes, always weight loss helps in reducing our diabetes complication. How to follow the weight loss? Following the 5 frequent meal pattern. Instead of having at once, you need to split your carbohydrates. Suppose you are taking breakfast, there should be a carbohydrate like along with the protein. And in between one, you can have one fruit and also have lunch by 1:30 and early dinner. There should be 2 to 3 hours of gap between dinner and the sleep time. So that whatever the carbohydrates you are consuming, it will get converted into the glycogen. So otherwise, if you sleep soon after your dinner, then it will go on accumulate as a fat and the weight loss will become very difficult. Add more of fibers in the diet to reduce the weight and also to maintain your blood sugar levels. Avoid all the refined products. Avoid white rice. You can have white rice. It is not compulsory to completely stop it. You can have it, but have it in the lunch, not in the dinner. So dinner has to be like balanced with complex carbohydrate, fiber and the protein. Yes, hi Shashilisha for your like. Hi Spurti Naresh. Hi Utkarsh. Suggest veg keto. Yeah, so keto diet is always a thing where we need to completely avoid the carbohydrates. Keto is very difficult in the vegetarian diet because all the vegetarian, it has the carbohydrates in that. But I would never recommend regarding the keto diet because I always believe in the balanced diet. Keto means you have to load yourself with the protein and the high fat food where we have to completely avoid taking carbohydrates. Completely avoid taking carbohydrates, loading yourself protein and fat. There will be another complications that the uric acid levels will go high and the fat percentage will go high and cholesterol levels will go high. All this condition we can face if we follow the keto diet, and keto diet we will not be able to follow it for long term. When we are into the keto diet, even you have to be very conscious about selecting your toothpaste, so that should not have any sugar in that. So I would recommend you to follow the balanced meal pattern where you can replace your simple carbohydrate with the complex carbohydrates. Yes, hi Aisha. Yes, so there should be a 55% of our food has to come from the carbohydrates, because when what is the substitute of sugar? Yes, substitute of sugar is stevia is the best substitute of sugar. You can, it is a naturally and derived from the plant sources. So substitute of sugar is you can use stevia. Otherwise, the best substitute for controlling the cravings is you can add fruits. You can add a small bite of jaggery. And also dates are the good substitute of sugar to control your sugar cravings. Hi Vishal, my dad is a chain smoker and diabetic also. Okay, so Vishal, always smoking increases the chances of high cholesterol levels in the body. The chain smoker means the controlling the blood sugar levels will become very difficult. So guide him and educate him how you can reduce smoking and educate him how you can control his blood sugar levels. So always smoking increases the stress in the body. The cortisol levels increases, that again increases the blood sugar levels. So avoiding smoking is really helps to control blood sugar levels. Is intermittent fasting good for pre-diabetes condition? Yes, Ramesh, intermittent fasting is good, but it depends how you are fasting. Like there is a 12 hours of fasting, there is a 16 hours of fasting. When you are fasting, then there will be an increase of the cravings will be there. So suppose if you are taking food by 8 p.m., the next day your food will come only in the 12 noon or in the 1 p.m. There should not be complete fasting has to be followed. So again, there is a chance of increasing your carbohydrate in cravings because your body starts to demand for more carbohydrate. Okay, because of sudden drop in the blood sugar, when your body is not sufficient to get the carbohydrate, then it starts to taking it from the muscles, stored muscles and the fat. So that time what happens, you start getting the muscle loss. So intermittent fasting is good, so but you cannot be able to follow it in the long term. So you can try 12 hours of fasting and the 16 hours of fasting. In the same time, you have to keep monitoring your blood sugar levels. When the pre-diabetes condition is there, there will be the always insulin resistance. So fluctuation will be there. Sudden dropping of blood sugar levels we can observe. So make sure that the continuous monitoring you are doing. Yes. So when the carbohydrates we are lacking, so almost we get cravings in the evening time. Otherwise, we get cravings in the midnight. Why we get the cravings? So our body, there are series of metabolic activities will go in the body, like circulation, digestion, respiration, and conducting the nerve function. All this requires energy. When our body is lacking with the energy, when our body is lacking with the carbohydrates, to get the energy, our body starts to take energy from the stored muscle mass. So that time we start getting the muscle loss and also fat loss we can get, and those who are uncontrolled blood sugar levels, the whatever the carbohydrates you are taking, whatever the sweets you are taking, the all the carbohydrates will go on accumulating in the blood, but it will not convert it into as the glycogen. Okay, so that time the glycogen will not utilize as a energy. That time what happens, our body starts to take the energy from the muscle mass. So that's the reason the always those who are having the high blood sugar levels always get the muscle loss. Muscle loss, we have to increase our muscle in protein intake in the form of high biological proteins, like you can go with the egg white, you can go with the lean mass, by taking milk is a good source of protein, even with the paneer, low fat paneer. All this if we increase, that helps to improve our muscle percentage. Yes, so any other doubts? So one thing is, we always look into the concentrate on the protein intake that we are taking. Always it should be the high biological protein. And when it comes to the fruits, always there is a myth that we have to avoid, complete stop taking the fruits. What kind of fruits we need to take? What is the portion of fruits we have to take? Always the fruits are, it is rich of sources of fructose. Again, it is a complex carbohydrates. It will not increase our blood sugar levels suddenly. How the sucrose, how the sugar increases our blood sugar levels. Again, there is a two kinds of fruits we get. One is the low glycemic index fruits. Another one is the high glycemic index fruits. What are the low glycemic index fruits? Low glycemic index fruits are apple, oranges, and papaya, muskmelon. All this comes under the low glycemic index fruits. So these fruits, the low glycemic index, the glycemic index of the fruits are less than 55 or 55. We consider it as a low glycemic index. So these fruits we take that helps to control our that helps to manage our blood sugar levels, and also that helps to control our sweet cravings. So always the low glycemic index fruits we can take. Hi Purnima, can diabetic patients take fruits in the night? Purnima, always the preferable time for taking fruits is always in the mid morning time, between breakfast and the lunch. So the thing is, when we take fruits in the evening, because again fructose has fructose, it is the form of sugar. When we take fruits in the evening, that go on accumulate in the body, and also it forms the layer over the undigested food, and that causes the delayed digestion, and always the blood sugar levels will increase. And so that's the reason we have to always take the fruits in the mid-morning time, not in the night. So the preferable time for taking the fruits is within 6 p.m., not after that. Okay, so one fruit per day. One fruit per day, we can keep it as a keep it for the diabetic person. Those fruits are apple can be taken, oranges can be taken, and guava can be taken. Papaya is very good. Okay, so these things, these fruits we can take. Again, when it comes to the fruits, high glycemic index are banana is high in glycemic index, mango is high in glycemic index, sapota is very high in glycemic index. These kinds of fruits we can avoid, but I would recommend to take the seasonal fruits, but in the restricted amount. Like suppose if you are taking mango, the one or two slices of mango can be enjoyed during the mango season. Yes. So, because when the seasonal fruits we take, seasonal fruits, all the seasonal fruits are enriched with the specific nutrients in that. So, the specific nutrients and the specific micronutrients and the these will give us antioxidants to protect our body. So, we can enjoy the seasonal fruits, but the thing is, what is the quantity that we are taking? When we take more quantity, so suppose if we take the one or two mangoes per day and every day during the mango season, always there will be in peak of high blood sugar levels. Okay, so keep the blood sugar levels, manage your blood sugar levels and enjoy your seasonal fruits, and one or two slices of mangoes or one or a small sapota can be taken during the mid-morning time and not in the evening time. Hi Darshita, hi Anusha. Yes. Yeah, so these kind of food we have to always consider, and reading the nutritive labels is plays an important role in developing the awareness in the diabetes person. So whenever we go on purchasing the processed food, so we have to always make a habit of checking the nutritive labels. So we'll come to know what is the percentage of sugar that we are taking in particular food. Suppose what is the percentage of fat that we are taking. Always follow the nutritive labels so that we can manage our blood sugar levels as well. Okay, so coming to the awareness in the family. So whenever we are having the history of parental history of diabetes, so always we have to consider that that there is a chance of getting diabetes in future. So how we can avoid? So we have to maintain our healthy lifestyle, and the sedentary lifestyle if we follow, there is a chance of getting the blood sugar diabetes condition very soon. So always we have to keep ourselves active and we have to manage our healthy weight and follow the balanced meal so that the history of the parental history of diabetes that we can postpone. Okay, so always the high body weight, obese condition, there will be the insulin resistance in the body. So what is the insulin resistance? Insulin resistance means our body is producing insulin properly, but it is not being utilized by the body to convert glucose into the glycogen, because the whatever the food that we take, it go on accumulating in the blood and increases our sugar levels. Why it happens? Because of the more visceral fat. When the fat around the belly side is more, that leads to the insulin resistance, and our always we get the sugar levels on the borderline in the obese person, otherwise on higher side. How we can control this insulin resistance? So following the healthy diet and the regular 30 minutes of exercises helps to control our insulin resistance. Add regular vegetables in the diet. Follow the healthy follow the fibers, like all the vegetables are good sources of fiber, and follow the plate concept. What is that plate concept? Like half of our plate has to be filled with the vegetables, and remaining one fourth has to be filled with the protein sources, and rest with the complex carbohydrates. What are complex carbohydrates? So what are protein? What kind of protein we need to take? Complex carbohydrates are like if we take millets. Millets are come under the complex carbohydrates. All millets are good. Okay, and we can go with the bran also. These are the good sources of complex carbohydrate. Whole wheat and ragi and all these things are good sources of complex carbohydrate. And all the vegetables are good sources of complex carbohydrate. Yes, so these are the things we need to add. So avoid the all whites in the diet. All whites means maida, white sugar, white rice. So all this will help. Whenever we take the white rice, polished rice, all the nutrients from the rice will go, and we are just taking the simple carbohydrates. So that again increases the chances of getting diabetes in future. So replace it with brown rice. Brown rice, it has the husk in that. It is a good sources of fiber. It is a good sources of micronutrients. So that helps to maintain your glycemic level. So blood sugar levels in the body. And when it comes to the protein, what kind of protein we need to take? So proteins means the high biological value protein. Suppose it should not be the red meat. Red meat, again, it is high in fat. So go with the chicken, the lean meat like fish is a good sources of protein and the omega-3 rich fatty acids. And if it comes to the chicken is also good sources of protein. Paneer is a good sources of protein. All the milk products are good sources of protein that can be taken. Milk, again it comes, there should be the skimmed milk. We have to go with the skimmed milk. So whenever we arrange the plate, we always look into that whether it is complete with the fiber portion or not, vegetable portion, protein portion, as well as the carbohydrate portion. So if we manage our plate concept like this, then it is very easy to control our blood sugar levels. Yes, and how frequently we have to monitor our blood sugar levels and how frequently we need to visit our endocrinologist. So it is regarding the blood sugar levels, there will be continuous changes we can find. Like we have to check our HbA1c, glycosylated hemoglobin, once in 3 months. That gives the accurate result like how the sugar levels are fluctuating since last 3 months. Okay, so depending on that, we'll come to know how is your glycemic control, blood glucose control. And we need to visit the endocrinologist once in 3 months or once in a 6 months, and we have to monitor our renal parameters once in 3 months, monitor your vitamin D levels, vitamin B12 levels, lipid levels, so that you will come to know how the parameters are under control. So if the parameters, if you can control this, and it is the awareness if you develop, then you can always control your future complications. So what will be the future complications? So the complications, like if we avoid the the high blood sugar levels, if we leave it untreated, so there may be a chance of increasing our complications, like it may affect our kidney, it may affect our eyesight, and there may be a chance of getting into the vascular diseases like heart attack, otherwise forming the plaques in the arteries. All this condition we will feel in the future. So that's the reason we have to always aware about our parameters, like if is there any fluctuation in the cholesterol levels, we have to be first careful about that, and monitor, control the cholesterol levels by following the healthy lifestyle and healthy diet. Okay, if there is any fluctuation in the renal parameter, we always meet our doctor to see whether the parameters are really on higher side, otherwise danger zone. We have to always keep monitoring that. Okay, so, and also monitoring the retina examination. Retina examination has to be done once in 6 months to keep our eyes healthy. So if we keep the awareness about these conditions, then we can always control our diabetes complication, and we can educate our family members too. Okay, so we are going to end the session. Yeah, if you have any doubts or queries, you can always reach out to us in the Truweight app. We are there to help you. And thank you so much for joining us and asking your queries. And all the very best, and reach out to us through the Truweight Facebook section. Thank you. Thank you so much.